I met Jim, I guess, was the first practice we had in the 84 fall season. He was coming in as an incoming freshman. I was one of the tri-captains with Jeff Kerr and Billy Vitolo. And Jimmy and a bunch of other freshmen came in, and, you know, you could kind of tell he was a good player right away. Tall, lanky, just a fun guy, and I think he fit in pretty quickly.
Baseball was something I took on as a little kid in Brooklyn growing up, probably about 4 or 5 years old. My brothers, we always, whether it be in front of the house, up the block, our neighbor's garage, always had a bat and a ball. A guy on my block, a kid, a few years older than me, Greg, and he was my babysitter for times. And he wound up going to John Jay College. And I used to play catch with Greg. He was a little older than me, and he would teach me pitching and show me things. And he mentioned, you know, to Lou, hey, I got this, you know, kid, you know, this kid, he's only a sophomore, whatever I was in high school. And then I started seeing Lou at the ballparks, at my sandlot games, at my high school games, early in the season when he could make it. And, you know, it was something from there. I just, I never thought of anything else but going to play baseball at John Jay for Lou. You know, the memories that I from John Jay are just phenomenal. And I played for 2.5 seasons. Basically, we were all from around New York City, the five boroughs. The friendships from not only the people I played with, but from the people that I met, alumni, guys that played before me, with me, and the guys that played after me. I was just turned 20 years old when I went on the police department in 1987. And I just felt at that time, that was gonna be, I transitioned from baseball. Baseball had brought me to that point, given me the mindset, the discipline that I needed. And I think in the long run, I felt that that was now my time to go on and you know, finish baseball, start my career, and something that I wanted to do for a long time. I think pursuing my degree and 3.5 years of going to night school while working full time put me in full focus, probably a better focus than I have. It definitely was a better focus than I have when I was playing baseball with the John Jay, because I think, at least academically wise, I definitely prospered, and I understood the value of education. I retired from the police department and started a job with New York State, and where my college degree was pretty much required for me to get that position, and it was something that later on in my life, 30 plus years later, manifested itself into another, you know, allowing me again to continue on with a job and a profession that I really enjoyed. So I remember alumni events for the baseball teams and guys coming back and going back, you know, to meet different people from different eras. The friendships, just knowing these men from alumni events, and like I said, some of them, you know, could be 10 plus years older than me, and some of them could be 10 plus years younger than me. But we get together, we bond, we talk, and you know, it's that whole family. I might as well have played with them, because I feel like they're teammates, and they'll be teammates forever.
I just think he's very deserving of the induction, as are the other ones, and I just want to congratulate everybody that's being inducted from last year to this year. All of them, I just want to wish the best and tell them congratulations.
When they mentioned to me that I would be an inductee into the John Jay College Athletics Hall of Fame, I probably cried. I know I did. To be surrounded by and to make friends, both then and later and previous, it's something that'll last forever, and it really makes everything come full circle.